With me in the studio today, I've got Jamie Boyton from Capital Drilling. Jamie, good to see you. Good morning.
Thank you, Andrew. Nice to be here.
You've had your trading update out in the last couple of weeks, Q1. I suppose the big focus, not just in the quarter, but looking ahead for this year, it's this shift in focus to West Africa. Is that correct?
That's correct. We the business started life in Tanzania and Zambia and the East Africa region, and West Africa for us has been, we've been there since 2010. It is a market that is multiple times larger than the markets in which we operate, but just frankly because we've been busy in East Africa, we haven't had the opportunity to expand the way we wanted to. So this year we're actually in the process of doubling our fleet capacity in the region. We're currently sitting close to 30 rigs now. They've actually been landing in Mauritania, Mali and the Ivory Coast. Mm-hmm. We've established presences in Mali and the Ivory Coast in the first quarter in terms of offices, warehouses, workshops. And we're starting to see an increase in tendering, which is very positive. So the strategy, that is certainly going to be the focus this year and first quarter and into the second quarter, working well so far.
So working well. And I suppose, given this shift in focus, you've had a few rigs idle in the quarter, contributing to a slight drop in overall revenue. Is that fair?
That's true. The market is obviously was in a downturn for exploration services in general and for drilling services in general. It emerged from that sort of in the latter part of 2016-17, but unfortunately there's some disruption in the political environment in Tanzania. So we've taken the opportunity to move rigs that aren't being utilised across to West Africa, so as a result utilisation's lower. Mm-hmm. and therefore revenue a little lower in the first quarter.
Utilisation a bit lower, but average monthly revenue per rig up a touch.
That's correct, and that's a metric that measures the output of the rigs that are actually working, and that's been on the increase now for 12 odd months, which is a sign that the contracts that we're actually operating on are performing increasingly well.
And these contracts you're converting from shorter term to longer term contracts?
Yeah, that's absolutely a goal for us. We started as an exploration drilling company which is characterised by shorter term contracts. As we evolve, we've moved into blast hole and grade control drilling, which are longer term contracts. So we have a number of contracts in Egypt and Tanzania in particular that are 5-year contracts, and we were recently awarded a 3-year contract with Resolute in Mali at the Syama gold mine. So it's adding to our suite of long term contracts, and that's absolutely a focus for the company.
You've also got a contract with Acacia Mining as
well?
We do.
We operate with Acacia at the North Mara gold mine in Tanzania. And the North Mara gold mine and the Anglo Gold Ashanti's Gator gold mine is the other one we have in Tanzania.
What's your view on the regulatory changes that we've seen in Tanzania?
It's been a challenging 12 to 18 months in Tanzania, obviously. There has been some recent progress, which has been really pleasing to see. The Mining Commission has now been formed. The regulations came out in January and the Mining Commission formed literally in the last couple of weeks. So there are certainly signs that things are starting to turn positive. And I think in general the mood toward Tanzania is starting to improve from a lower base, yes.
And as far as your customers, your clients are concerned, are predominantly mid-tier companies, also some majors in the mix as well?
Yeah, we've always had a bit of a weighting toward mid-tier and majors, the likes of Anglo Gold Ashanti, Acacia, Centamin, Kinross. The other thematic, though, that we're seeing at the moment is the return of exploration, which is characterised generally by some of the smaller companies. And it's good to see them back in the market. They were absent for a good 4-odd years, so it's nice to see that coming back into the market.
What do you reckon makes Capital Drilling unique as a company?
Well, the DNA of the company is Africa. That's where we were born. That's where we do business. We know how to operate there. But I think what makes us unique is we're actually, as we've evolved from an exploration drilling company, we've evolved to actually offer the full suite of drilling. So we do exploration, we do grade control, we do blast hole, we do shot firing services. So we are quite unique and we can offer the full range of services.
And offering a dividend to shareholders?
Yes,
as well?
Yeah, we've been paying dividends for about 3 years now. We have a very solid balance sheet. We actually went ex-dividend about a week or so ago. That gets paid on the 18th of May, I think it is. So yes, we're quite unique in that we pay dividends as well, yes.
Are you happy with growth, with how the company's progressing?
I'm happy with we're having a year-on-year drop in revenue, as we discussed earlier, as part of redeploying assets, but I'm certainly happy that we are executing on the strategy. We are increasing our presence on tender lists, and I'm really optimistic for the year ahead.
And you've got some pretty supportive shareholders as well?
We have, yeah. We've obviously been listed in London since 2010. We've got the founding shareholders and some very high quality institutions on the register here in London.
Right, so Q2, as you were saying a moment ago, looking pretty busy so far, and you're looking forward to the year ahead, are you?
Yeah, look, Q1 was really in line with our expectations. Q2, I think, is also trading in line with expectations. However, I'd say the momentum in the sector is actually, and the momentum for the company is picking up, so we're pretty positive on the second half.
Jamie, really good to see you. Thanks very much.
Thank you.